Hi, in this video I'm going to show you on how to generate an account statement, the invoice what we have created. So to create the account statement, first you need to check in the customer master data what we have created, which is 8 50s. I will go to the customer master data and check under correspondence. So we need to maintain the account statement, whether you want to maintain on a weekly basis or bi-weekly or monthly or yearly. So there will be an options on how to you can generate a account statement. So to generate the account statement, first you need to check on the master data. Now we are in the our customer master data and click on enter the customer number. What is a XYZ company? Here, when you go to the account correspondence, you can see the account statement where actually you can maintain the account statement ID. So this ID where you are going to call the report. So regarding the forms, how it is assigned, also I'm going to show you that information, but we didn't do any configuration how the system is generating the account statement, and I will show it. So you can see here, so we have a weekly, monthly and yearly. So I choose a monthly account statement here. So now I'm going into the account statement to generate account statement. You can go accounting, financial accounting, account receivable and periodic processing. So I usually use a not individual, I usually use a multiple selection. So if you want to generate for a range of customers, and then it's always recommend use FDAT 27. You need to go to the financial accounting. Accounts receivable. And periodic processing. I usually go here and then print correspondence. Here F.27. So this is an individual request you can do. I just go to the F.27 to do the like a more than one or a single you can generate. So here I'm going to give my company code TR03 and customer number. Master indicator is always 2. Key date, I'm just going to give 30. We posted an invoice on 1st of January, so I just give on the end of the month 020. So here you can choose the correspondence. system will show the correspondence. So I'm going to use this account statement, you know. So double click on it, and now I just give, this is LP01 is the standard one. Click on execute. You can see here one periodic statement was requested, so click OK. Then you can see correspondence request was carried out or deleted. So now you can see the correspondence request was selected. Would you like to issue the request? Yes. So now the system is going to generate an account statement. So you can see the spool was generated. To check the spool, you can go to the system and one spool request. So when you go on spool request, the system is going to show only the spools created for use. Maximum sessions was reached, so in this case I just go SP01 and so go to SP01, click on execute. So it will show on 2 days how many spools are generated. So the latest spool is this one. So when you click on, you can actually click on this, then the system will show our customer invoice, and you can see this is our correspondence number and the printer and which company code. So this is how the title is generating here. So how many pages? Yeah, you can see this is only one page statement. So here is the one, the account statement. You can see no posting for the period. So you can see on from 30th to 30th. So actually what we did, it's generated only for that particular date. Since the posting was done on the first, actually the system is taking as a carried forward. So what I'm going to show you again, let us see what invoice details the system is going to show you here when you generate a statement a particular period. So when you double click on this, TR03 customer 800, and this is indicator here. Actually we need to give 01/01/2020 and 30/01/2020. So the system will generate a statement not only this particular date, it will generate for all the days in that month. So click on execute. Now let's see what's how the system is going to show. Okay, the first time usually system take longer time than expected. The second time when you are doing the transaction, it will be quite fast. So now the statement is generated, you can see. So now I go to the /NSP01. Execute. This is the one what is generated. So when I click on here, the system show the account statement. So now you can see. So now you can see here, and the system is showing what is the document number and also the date and the document type and also the currency. All these details you can see. The final balance as on this date is this one. This is showing as a carried forward 0, which is maybe from the 2019 there is 0. So the transaction for this month is only one period. Yes, this is how the system generate the account statement. So how you can download in the PDF and back to this account statement, you can select statement, spool forward. Yes, so actually you have an option whether you want to export as a PDF or a local file. So export as a text also you can do, and the PDF it's grayed out. And but yeah, in your system, the live system, you will be having the functionality to export as a PDF, and you can select the spool and then you can export this. Yeah, this is how you can generate the account statement for the customers. And yeah, thank you for watching. And in the case of FIAR reports, you can just directly go FIAR, then the system will, the easy access here, SAP easy access will be changed as SAP easy access account receivables. You see, reports for accounts receivable. So this here is all the reports where you can use for the account receivable and due date analysis. So regarding the open item management and open items, yes, I will be coming up with the next topic. Yeah, thank you for watching.